What's going on, everyone, and welcome back to the Night Owl channel, and welcome back to the series where we're counting down the top Dynasty Warriors characters. And coming in at number 78, we have the very first antagonist you go against in Zhang Zhao. Zhang Zhao was a sorcerer who used fire attacks to do substantial amount of damage to you while you tried to attack him. You can also use him in free mode and stuff like that, and while you play with him, you did a substantial amount of damage with his fire attacks. And that's why for the intro, I was teasing his little magical abilities. But let's go ahead and jump into who Zhang Zhao is for those who don't know. So like I said, Zhang Zhao was the first antagonist that you go against. He's the first main boss that you fight against. He forms the force known as the Yellow Turbans. It's one of the most famous battles of all time during this time. And it's usually the first battle that you play when you play the Dynasty Warriors series. So people that have played the game at least once or twice should definitely know who this guy is. He was formerly a doctor that became the leader of the infamous Yellow Turbans, the army fighting for a religious sect known as the Way of Peach. Accompanied by his brothers Zhang Liang and Zhang Bao, who are also sorcerers. Every time you go against them, they throw rocks at you, or they shoot wind at you and lightning and all this crazy stuff. So he began a rebellion against a corrupt and indifferent Han Dynasty. Their struggle forms the basis of the Three Kingdoms era. And the Romance of the Three Kingdoms, the book, was well known for depicting him as having ties to sorcery. Before we go any further, let's go ahead and look at the rankings for the leader of the Yellow Turbans. In the first popularity poll, he receives 431 votes out of a total of 75,000, putting him at 60th place, which makes him the highest person so far that we've seen. And then in the second one, he's actually dead last at 83rd. And then in my personal rankings, he's up at 62nd, which averages out to the 78th spot. So those who have played Dynasty Warriors, at least for a little bit, if you played the first stage of a main story mode, you've definitely heard of this character. You've definitely, you know, run into him. And he's definitely a memorable person, and he's got a very eccentric manner to him. He's very, the way he talks is kind of weird, and his body, and he's very over the top when it comes to like his speeches and stuff like that, always mentioning heaven or the Way of Peace or something like that. But then like most of his battles that, or most of the Yellow Turban Rebellion stages, begin with the slaughter of the people that he's trying to get rid of, which is kind of weird. But anyway, you know, Zhang Zhao has been in the game since the very first Dynasty Warriors. He's the main antagonist at the very first stage. And let's take a look at how he's changed over the last 20 years. So we're going to start off with his voice acting.
Unleash your rage, my chosen children!
We shall push forward! We will create a new world of peace!
Greetings, Dong Zhuo. I am back, my old enemy, but I am here to help you in your quest to rid the land of Lu Bu.
He's got a voice that nobody else really has in the game. He's got a very unique voice, and the people that play him do a very good job of portraying him, except for maybe Dynasty Warriors 9. Dynasty Warriors 9 was like all right, you know, they did an okay job. But I think the person who did him from Dynasty Warriors 4 through Dynasty Warriors 8, which was the same person, Doug Stone, he did a great job voicing Zhang Jia. It just fits his character pretty well, and that's what I kind of am used to, because he's, you know, he was his voice actor for so long. So yeah, not much change on his voice acting, and definitely, you know, not any complaints or anything like that. Let's go on to his outfit. Now, Zhang Zhao has a bunch of different outfits that basically revolve around the same thing. He wears a robe, he's got his, you know, his medallions on. His hair changes every now and then. He goes from having, like, long hair, and he goes from having, like, Mel Gibson Braveheart hair, you're looking like a normal sage, and then he goes to, like, balding with a long, long beard, and then he goes back to this weird, like, five-star haircut. And then as he comes back to Dynasty Warriors 9, he goes back into like a, it's just like a single cone on his head. I mean, it fits with his character. He's very wacky, very like, you know, he's very out there when it comes to his character and his model and stuff like that. So his character himself definitely fits him. In the 8th and 9th games, actually, Zhang Zhao's hair is visibly modeled after a star and a moon. That's why I said he has that weird like star pattern. And then the 9th one, I guess that's what the curve is for. But it looks more like a cone than it does a moon. That's just my opinion. But like I said, his outfit doesn't change very much. And he's pretty recognizable with his outfits. Don't have much to complain about there. Let's go ahead and talk about his weapon style, which is also pretty quick. Because, I mean, he has the same weapon style since Dynasty Warriors 3. In Dynasty Warriors 2, I mean, he had the sword. But from Dynasty Warriors 3 and on, he has used the staff, which allows him to shoot fire out of it And he's kind of had the same moveset since Dynasty Warriors 3 as well. When I first played him in Dynasty Warriors 3, he had the little range attack where he could, like, shoot out a flamethrower, which is pretty cool. And he does it in Dynasty Warriors 9 as well. They've kept his moveset close to his roots, and they don't have to worry about getting used to playing him again. If anybody plays him, I'm not sure if anybody really plays Zhang Zhao. They might just like him just because of his character, but he doesn't really have much playability, especially in his story in Dynasty Warriors 9. I mean, Dynasty Warriors 9 follows the historical route of the Three Kingdoms, so, you know, Zhang Zhao is only there for a few battles, and then, you know, he gets killed because he gets, you know, taken down by He Jin and the Allied forces, so. Alright, so we covered his outfit, his voice acting, weapons, and there's not much else to really talk about except, I guess, his relationships, which he has with two non-playable characters, which is his younger brothers, Zhang Bao and Zhang Liang.
Zhang Bao, Zhang Bao, I grant you power.
Ah, I feel the power! Infidels! Prepare to be judged!
Behold!
Now, both of them are also sorcerers as well. In every instance of the Yellow Turban Rebellion stage, they are always split from each other, and whichever way you go, you will run into some sort of magic ability that they have, whether it's fire and ice, rocks and wind, or lightning and, you know, rain or something. They always have something, so whichever way you go, because you have to go through one of them always to get to Zhang Jiao to kill him and beat him and complete the stage. Those two always cause a little bit of trouble for you as you make your way to him. But Zhang Jiao doesn't have much. I mean, he dies. He loses in the battle, so he gets killed, but he was also sick when the Yellow Turban Rebellion took place, so his illness kind of played a factor in it as well. I gotta be honest, even though he was sick, I think the Allied forces would have definitely had him, regardless if he was sick or not. They had a lot of talented people in their ranks, so it wouldn't have been too difficult. Zhang Zhao is like that one friend or that person when you're walking by and they, you know, they stop you and you're like, hey, you want to hear about, you know, our service this Saturday or Sunday, and you should definitely come look at us. And they, you know, try to take you up your time. And but Zhang Zhao was in a different time, so instead of going up to people and asking them about it, he would just, you know, hey, you know, join my cause or die kind of thing. You know, he was very, I wouldn't say arrogant, but Zhang Zhao looked down upon people who opposed him because he believed he was the vassal of, you know, the gods. After reading the book that led him to, you know, basically preaching about the way of peace and heaven and all the other good stuff, he became quite egotistical with himself, believing that he couldn't be taken down because of his almighty powers and, you know, the, you know, sorcery that he possesses and all that other stuff. But other than that, guys, that's all I really have for Zhang Zhao. I mean, he's not one of my favorite characters. He doesn't really play that big of a role. Everybody knows who he is. Like I said, he's a very memorable person because, you know, it's Zhang Zhao. He's the first guy you go against. He talks funny. He's got magic abilities. And, you know, he shoots fire and all that other stuff. So he's a memorable character. He's just not one of my favorites. And according to the polls, he's not really anybody else's favorites either. But Zhang Zhao is 78th on our list. That's pretty much all I have for him. I hope you guys enjoyed the episode. And I hope you guys are looking forward to number 77. I'm going to try to get through these episodes a little quicker. I don't know when Dynasty Warriors 10 is coming out, but I definitely want to get them all done before Dynasty Warriors 10. There's a couple other things I want to do with the series as well. So like I said, guys, hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, definitely appreciate a like, comment, and subscribe. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Thanks for watching, everyone.
Long be the reign of the Yellow Turban!